Hi everyone, myself Shijit from E-Content Development Center, Majlis Arts and Science College, Puramannur. So welcome to my class, Income Tax Law and Practices for the 5th semester BCom students. So in this class, we are going to discuss the tax treatment of some important retirement benefits which are comes under the head income from salary. So as we know, as per income tax, the total income of a person is charged under 5 heads. That is income from salary, income from house property, profit or gain from the business or profession, then income from other sources and capital gains. So under the head income from salary, there are different elements. So under the head income from salary, there are different elements such as basic pay, arrears of salary, advance salary, bonus, commission, allowances, perquisites, provident fund and some retirement incomes such as gratuity, encashment of earned leave, pension, compensation on retrenchment, compensation of voluntary retirement, etc. So today in this class we are going to discuss the tax treatment of gratuity, encashment of earned leave and pension. So first one, gratuity, section 10, subsection 10. Okay, gratuity is a retirement benefit. It is given by the employer to the employee as a gratitude for the past service rendered by him. So comes to the tax treatment of gratuity. In the case of government employees, any death cum retirement gratuity received by a government employee is fully exempted from tax. Okay, so in the case of government employee, the amount received as gratuity is fully exempted from tax. So the government employee do not have to pay any tax for the amount received as gratuity. Then in the case of non-government employees, for tax purpose, the non-government employees are classified into two, that is employees covered under the Payment of Gratuity Act 1972 and employees not covered under the Payment of Gratuity Act 1972. So first case, employees covered under the Payment of Gratuity Act 1972. So those employees, they are covered under the provision of Payment of Gratuity Act, can get an exemption to the extent of least of the following. First one, gratuity actually received. Then second one, rupees 20 lakh. Okay, it is a statutory limit, rupees 20 lakh. Then 15 days salary for each completed year of salary. Okay, which is calculated as salary drawn in the last month into 15 divided by 26 into year of service. Okay, once again, 15 days salary is calculated as salary drawn in the last month into 15 divided by 26. 26 means number of working days in a month into year of service. Here, the fraction service above 6 months will be considered as 1 year. Okay, for example, the service of 1 year and 6 months is treated as service of 2 years. Okay, so the fraction service above 6 months will be treated as 1 year. Then notable point is that salary for this purpose includes basic pay plus dearness allowance. Okay, for the calculation, salary include basic pay plus dearness allowances, whether forming part of the payment or not. Okay, I repeat, for those employees coming under the provision of Payment of Gratuity Act will get an exemption to the least of the amount. First one, actual amount received. Second one, statutory limit, that is 20 lakh. Then third one, 15 days salary for each completed year of service. Okay, so we will consider these three amounts and we will select the least amount, that will be the exempted amount. Okay, then comes to the second case, that is employees not covered under the Payment of Gratuity Act 1972. Those employees not coming under the provision of Payment of Gratuity Act 1972 will get an exemption to the list of the below. First one, gratuity actually received. Second one, rupees 20 lakh, that is the statutory limit. And third one, half month salary for each completed year of service based on average salary of 10 months immediately preceding the month of retirement. Okay, once again I repeat, least of the amount is exempted from the amount received as gratuity. ഫസ്റ്റ് വൺ ഗ്രാറ്റുവിറ്റി ആക്ച്വലി റിസീവ്ഡ്, സെക്കൻഡ് വൺ ദി സ്റ്റാറ്റ്യൂട്ടറി ലിമിറ്റ് ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് 20 lakh, ദെൻ തേർഡ് വൺ ഹാഫ് മന്ത് സാലറി ഫോർ ഈച്ച് കംപ്ലീറ്റഡ് ഇയർ ഓഫ് സർവീസ് വിച്ച് ഇസ് കാൽക്കുലേറ്റഡ് ബേസ്ഡ് ഓൺ ദി ആവറേജ് സാലറി ഓഫ് 10 months ഇമ്മീഡിയറ്റ്ലി പ്രിസീഡിംഗ് ദി മന്ത് ഓഫ് റിട്ടയർമെൻറ്. ഹിയർ ഫ്രാക്ഷൻ സർവീസ് ഈസ് ഇഗ്നോർഡ്. ഓക്കെ, നോട്ടബിൾ പോയിന്റ് ഈസ് ദാറ്റ് സാലറി ഫോർ ദിസ് പർപ്പസ് ഇൻക്ലൂഡ് ബേസിക് പേ, then DA when given part of the payment, then commission based on a fixed percentage on the turnover. Okay, once again, for the computation, salary include basic pay plus dearness allowance if it is given as a forming part of the employment, plus commission based on fixed percentage on turnover. Okay, so we were discussed about gratuity, the tax treatment of gratuity. So in the case of government employees, the full amount received as gratuity is fully exempted from tax. Okay, no tax is required to pay the amount received as gratuity in the case of government employees. Then in the case of other employees, the employees are classified into two, that is employees covered under the Payment of Gratuity Act 1972 and employees not covered under the Payment of Gratuity Act 1972. Then in the case of employees covered under the Payment of Gratuity Act 1972, least of the amount is exempted from the tax, that is actual amount received, then statutory limit rupees 20 lakh, then 15 days salary for each completed year of service. Then comes to the case of employees not covered under the Payment of Gratuity Act, least of the amount is exempted from tax, that is actual amount received as gratuity, then statutory limit rupees 20 lakh, then half month salary based on the average salary of 10 month immediately preceding the month of retirement. Okay, so next retirement income is that encashment of earned leave or simply earned leave salary. Sometimes the employees are eligible for earned leave which can be availed or encashed. Okay, earned leave simply means the leave with salary. In normal case, there will be a permissible earned leave. So if the employee did not avail this leave, he can encash it. Okay, encashment simply means converting into cash. So if the encashment is done during service, the full amount is taxable. Okay, if the encashment is done during the service, the full amount is taxable. Okay, the full amount received as encashment of leave is fully taxable if it is received during the service. Then second case, if encashment is done after retirement, the employee can avail tax exemption. Okay, so tax treatment of earned leave salary when it is encashed at the time of retirement. In the case of government employee, the full amount is exempted. Okay, in the case of government employee, the earned leave salary is fully exempted from tax. Then in the case of non-government employees, least of the following is exempted from tax, that is actual amount received as encashment of earned leave, then statutory limit rupees 3 lakh, then 10 month salary based on average salary of last 10 months, then cash equivalent of leave due at credit. So this amount, that is cash equivalent of leave due at credit, is calculated as average salary into leave due at credit into number of years of service. Okay, here leave at credit means leaves allowed minus leaves availed. Okay, which is subject to maximum of 30 days leaves for each completed year of service. Okay, which is subject to maximum of 30 days leave for each completed year of service. Okay, I repeat, the tax treatment of earned salary when the encashment of earned leave is done at the time of retirement. So in the case of government employee, the full amount is exempted from tax. Okay, in the case of government employee, the full amount received as encashment of earned leave is fully exempted from tax. Then in the case of non-government employees, least of the following amount is exempted from tax, that is actual amount received as encashment of earned leave, then rupees 3 lakh, that is the statutory limit, then 10 month salary based on average salary of last 10 months, then cash equivalent of leave due at credit. Okay, so the cash equivalent of leave due at the credit is calculated as average salary into leave at due. So the amount of cash equivalent of leave due at the credit is equal to average salary into leave at the credit into number of years of service. And leave at the credit is equal to leaves allowed minus leave availed. Okay, then it is subject to a maximum of 30 days leave for each completed year of service. Okay, so next retirement income is pension, section 10, subsection 10a. Okay, pension is also a retirement income. Then pension may be monthly pension or commuted pension. So in the case of monthly pension, it is fully taxable for both government and non-government employees. Okay, for the amount received as monthly pension, both government employees and non-government employees has to pay tax. Then in the case of commuted pension, there are exemption to tax. Commuted pension simply means receiving a lump sum amount at the time of retirement instead of receiving monthly pension. Okay, sometimes an employee may receive a lump sum amount at the time of retirement as commuted pension, okay, instead of receiving monthly pension. Okay, for the commuted pension, employee can avail the exemption as follows. In the case of government employees, the amount received as commuted pension is fully exempted. Okay, so for government employees, there is no need for payment of tax on the amount received as commuted pension. So in the case of non-government employees, 1/3 of full value of pension is exempted if he also receives the gratuity. Then half of the full value of pension is exempted if he does not receive the gratuity. Okay, I repeat, in the case of non-government employees, 1/3 of the full value of pension is exempted if he also receives the gratuity. Then 1/2 of the full value of pension is exempted if he does not receive gratuity. So it is the tax treatment of commuted pension. So today we have discussed the tax treatment of some of the important retirement incomes, that is tax treatment of pension, tax treatment of encashment of earned leave, and tax treatment of gratuity. Okay, so I hope all of you understand my class. Okay, thank you.